Yeah, I think it's recording. Yeah.
So this brother said that Jesus is God. He said yes. Okay. So then she was listening to him. We let him talk. Okay. So he finished, and then he read for us from Exodus, okay, chapter 33. He read us that God said, "There is no God beside me, and if any man see me, unless he die, or not see me." It's right. It's in the Bible. Okay. So my point is that when I asked him question, do you believe anything in this book? He said, no, I don't believe everything, but I believe that one that he read. And I explained to him, brother, what I'm saying to him is that, yes, he's right. In the Old Testament, no one called God the Father. No one at all. And God says so many places, I am the only God, no one beside me, and there is no other God beside me. He repeatedly say that. We agree that. Okay? But in the New Testament, Jesus came. Jesus came, even before Jesus came, there were prophecy. I can show you in Isaiah 53 that the Son will come. In Isaiah chapter 9, the virgin will have a son, and she will call him Jesus, he will be the Son of God. Okay, so we have this. This is we have on Old Testament. So it was prophesied before Jesus came. So it's fulfilled when Jesus came. The first person in the Bible to introduce us that God is our Father, Jesus, his own ways. Show you so many scripture here that this is not my father. And he's God says, this is my son, my blood son, I'm well pleased with him. Jesus was my father, God spoke, and John listened.
Yeah, our contention is that from the beginning, God said he's only one God. And he gave that message of all the prophets, only one Lord. So we want to know, when did God change from being one God to three in one?
No, I don't believe three in one.
You don't believe three in one?
No, I don't say three gods.
No, it's not. No, we don't say you have three gods, but you said, because the only verse that is closest to three, the concept of three, is in the first epistle of God, let me call it, first epistle of God, 5:7. So he didn't say three gods. First epistle of God, chapter 5, verse number 7. For there are three that bear record in heaven, the Father, the Word. Now give me an example.
In the Old Testament, as I said again, there's no one called God Father. God never said he has a son, nothing at all. The Jews themselves, the first people that were made, who never called him a father. They don't even say God, they say Lord. Okay, all Old Testament. But in Isaiah, they have prophecies talking about Jesus is coming.
From Isaiah.
In the New Testament, it's changed. Jesus begins to tell us, God is your father.
What I'm saying. When did God, what I'm saying?
You're
talking about the New Testament is eyewitness account.
Do you believe what he said? I say he's a prophet.
Not God incarnate.
That's fine. I'm happy that you believe a prophet. So do you believe what Jesus said?
I believe when Jesus said, excuse me, I believe
what
Jesus
said. No, I'm not going to pick.
You are picking and choosing.
No.
I'll tell you what I believe Jesus said.
I'm asking you a question. He says, if Jesus is a prophet, every Muslim loves Jesus. Yeah. I know that. Okay? But do you believe what he said about himself? Forget what other people said.
Do you believe in everything what Jesus said in the New Testament about himself, about the Father? Do you believe in it? Even everything? Okay, if you believe in the Testament, do you believe that Jesus is God?
Of course, if you believe Jesus is God,
that's a verse that all the Muslims have in court. And listen to me.
They always say that, where is the Bible?
I'm quoting John 17. John 17:3, do you know what it says?
But before you go there, wait. Don't worry, brother, I'll give you time.
I want to quote you.
I know you can quote me, but if you cut me, I might not even remember.
No, you
what
told
I'm
you asked me that some problem. I didn't cut
no,
you.
No, what I'm saying is that I am explaining to you in the Old Testament, that's what was exactly God, never been a father in the Old Testament, okay? He was always calling the Israel. desire to run to, know what your mother does, know what to do against, and whatever, we all know that. New Testament is different.
Are you telling me that is God of the Old Testament and the God of the New Testament? Is that two gods?
No.
So our condition is that in the Bible, God says something. What in the Bible? Did God change his mind when he came to the New Testament? Okay, if he doesn't change, let me quote with that. If God did not change his mind, if you go into the Bible, in the book of Exodus, chapter 20, verse number 3 to 5, which says, you shall have no other gods besides me. You shall not make for yourself a graven image or any likeness of anything that is in heaven above or that is in the earth beneath or that is in the water under the earth. You shall not bow down to them or serve them, for I, the Lord your God, am a jealous God. So why do you bow down to Jesus? Why do you worship Jesus? When Almighty God never changes mind. Tell me.
Okay, now, you're right. I'm agreeing with you what you said in the Old Testament, the Exodus, everything. But when Jesus comes, this is what Jesus introduced us as God is his father and our father.
Okay, but Jesus never said he is God. So why do you worship as God?
Okay, shall I show you why we call him God? Shall I show you?
Show me.
Okay, right. That's why I love the discussion.
We're not going to be long.
So the reason, number one, Jesus said himself that he came from above, he was not like us human beings. He said to the Jews, you are from beneath, I am from above. He said to them, I am the bread of life. He said to them, I am the light of the world. Jesus claimed alone, even Allah named 99 names, there's a name that is the truth, the life, the resurrection in the Quran, isn't it? And then when Jesus claimed those ones,
what I'm saying, we only want to know, okay. Sister.
Now, even here,
what uncle was telling you, he's the contents.
Can I read it out? Can I read it to you? Okay, this is Jesus speaking, okay? Jesus spoke those words, lifted up his eyes to heaven and said, Father, the hour has come, glorify your son. Okay, that your son also may glorify you, as you have given him authority over all flesh.
As you have given authority over as you have given all authority.
Yeah, God gave him.
God gave him, okay. Yes. So and he's God.
Yeah, wait, we're going to come back there. That he should give eternal life to as many as you have given him.
Yeah.
And this is eternal life, that they may know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent.
Jesus said, because Jesus was praying to the disciples. What did he say? 3? John 17, 3? That this is eternal life.
We want to
clarify.
Okay.
John 17, 1 to 2, Jesus was praying to God. But 3, what did he say? You read yourself. And this is eternal life.
Absolutely.
Jesus said to them, and this is eternal life. They might know you are the only true God.
Yes.
No, you are reading yourself. You said it.
You see, you
who is only? I didn't jump.
No, but let me finish, then you will understand.
No, before you finish, for say, who is the only true God there? You read it. Who?
Jesus is telling him he's the only true God.
Jesus was praying, not disciples are there. We're going to come back. He said, and this is eternal life. Hereby, no, the disciples might know that you are the only true God.
Absolutely.
And Jesus Christ, whom you have sent.
Yes.
So who is the only true God?
God.
God, who?
Yes.
God is only
God,
true
the creator,
God.
Of course.
Okay, and Jesus is God.
Absolutely.
So Jesus is the true God.
Hold on, wait. You see, don't jump me. Don't keep coming.
You read it yourself. Okay. I didn't read
of
it.
Course.
You said that Jesus said that this is eternal life.
You know what? Now, you're cutting me off.
No, I'm not cutting
that's
off.
That's no respect.
No, I'm not cutting off.
You wait until I finish.
Please. No, you didn't know what you're doing to me. I just came. I gave our time.
I am going to show you from the same Bible.
I didn't hear.
Brother, my darling, just listen to me, please. It's okay. Me and him are talking. We might not even disagree. We disagree, that's fine. That's why we're here to discuss with respect. I am reading this to you to show you Jesus' authority. Jesus has been given authority by his father. Do you believe God is Jesus' father? Do you believe?
No, we the Muslims.
You don't believe even he's the son of God?
No, we don't.
So it's not a point to them.
No.
The whole Bible,
no.
New Testament, it says that Jesus is the son of God. You understand?
But Jesus is the God.
Listen,
Jesus
we're
going to
come back.
God.
Okay, if I show you Jesus is God, one scripture, you're going to say to me, you will not believe it. I'm going to show it to you.
Before you digress, you read the Bible here. You read something here.
Okay, can I show you Jesus is God?
No, we're digressing. We've got to come back. Let's take your time. You said Jesus said.
Show you many.
No, you said Jesus is. Jesus said.
Let me finish. Let me show you one more scripture. and then after he can explain.
I said, let's stick with that first before we jump. Are you afraid of that verse?
No, I'm not. I read it
no,
to
no,
you.
No, but we're
to
discussing.
You. I'm not afraid.
Jesus said that.
But can I show him more scripture?
No, you can show
if
me later.
Make sense
no,
to
no,
you,
this we can't. But that makes no. sense. And
that
this is
sense?
Eternal life.
All right.
Jesus
shall
said,
I show
this,
you one more.
One minute.
Show me one more.
Wait, no, let's. Okay.
You're gonna have the time. I'm gonna listen to you for 20 minutes.
But when
minutes.
I talk, you give me. You ask me to. When I talk, you interject
brother,
him. So.
No, brother. Give me time. I'm proofing you. Jesus is God.
Go,
okay. He's Godhead, and he came from God. I wanna prove you. So if I'm gonna read it to you another one, just don't worry. After that, that's okay. You can explain to me
I
for
said,
20
I said
minutes.
Before, but I said before we digress, let's take one at a time. This is oh no, no listen to me. But this is a very, it's a very important verse. Jesus said that this is eternal life. That day you disciple my daughter, you are the only true God. The only
yes,
true God. Who is the only true God? No, who is the only true God?
Heavenly Father.
Heavenly Father.
Yes.
Jesus. Who is Jesus then?
He's his son.
But his son is God as well.
But he's yes, he's God.
But he's not
God.
A true God.
I'll show you.
He's contradictory.
I know it's not.
Okay,
it's
go,
not.
Go, go,
my
okay.
darling, I'll
okay,
show you
okay,
Quran,
go.
How your Quran contradicts.
Okay, go,
his
go,
son.
Go, okay, show me that.
I'll keep
on showing.
Okay, but now let me show you.
Let's have a look at the Quran is a contradiction.
Yeah, it is.
No,
it
no,
is.
Let's finish
that. Let me finish.
Because you know, yeah, he said he's got the Bible show me that Jesus is God. We're not going to go to Quran. We know that.
More interesting, maybe, yeah. If you're able to
brother,
show that he's three in
one. You interrupted us. Listen, this question we know for years. You repeat this question. When we have the Bible, we're showing you
okay,
from
go,
the Bible.
Go, okay, go, show,
let
show.
Me show you. In the beginning was the Word. In Quran, did Allah give word to Mary? Yes or no?
Yes.
He gave her a word. Who is this that word that Allah gave to Mary? Who was it? I'm asking a question. Who was it? Who did Allah give to Mary
Isa,
a word?
Isa.
Jesus. I'm sorry, Jesus.
I don't
yeah?
want you to lecture me. You're going to give me time to talk.
Of course, my darling.
Don't
I'll
ask
give
it.
Me half
okay,
an
go
hour.
Finish that.
Okay? So I'm just asking you, the word in here is Jesus, okay? Because you've got in the Quran the same. I've got it here with me. Allah gave to Mary a word.
Yes, that, what does that word mean? Is that word God?
No. Wait. Let me wait, my darling. Don't say anything, you will explain to me. So if Allah gave to Mary a word, so it says here in the beginning the word and in the beginning was the word. It was the word. And the word was with God. And the word was God.
Bottle number two.
Okay, wait. He was in the beginning with God.
Hold on. Who was in the beginning with God?
Jesus, because it's
so
the word.
So Jesus is God. Jesus is God with God. No,
when
he,
I finish,
he
I
was in the beginning
you.
With God. Who is God? Who was in the beginning with
brother,
God?
Brother,
no, you, when you ask me questions, I answer it. You want me to stop you?
Let me finish. Don't stop me. Don't interrupt me. Let me finish, and then it makes sense. Still, you might not believe. That's fine, brother. I'm not here to make anything.
Look.
Because I
listen to me.
Before I listen to you,
gotta give you time to talk
me,
as well.
Can I show you why I believe Jesus is God?
Show me. I'm here.
But you keep cutting me off. Okay. That's not fair.
But you, when
that's
I'm talking,
communication.
When you talk, you cut me
you
off several times.
I didn't. I'm asking.
I'll give
you
3 minutes. I don't want to lecture. 3 minutes. Go on.
Listen,
I'll keep quiet.
Might not even 3 minutes. Might even 1 minute. If you keep quiet, brother, I am gonna tell you why I believe Jesus came from God and he's also God. Okay. Now, he was in the beginning with God. Are you listening? You're not even listening.
Could you hold it?
You weren't even listening. So, in the beginning was the word. And the word that Allah gave to Mary. Okay? You all agree that. That's in the Quran. Okay? So, the word was with God and the word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things were made through him. And without him, nothing was made. So now, if God is our creator, obviously Jesus is claiming himself. He was made. In him was life, and the life was what? Light of man. And the light shined in the darkness, and the darkness is not comprehensible. So I'll give you time now. I don't want to go even far, but I can show you later on. So this is what I believe.
Okay, you believe
that Jesus is Godhead, even though he came as a man. I'm going to give you. I'm just explaining a little bit. I'm telling you what I believe. Okay?
I know, I know.
And you have to agree with me that I believe that's what
no,
I believe.
No, I'm not. No, you know, you are debating. No. You are debating uncle, and the uncle was died, and then you called me, and you're Muslim.
Now,
let me explain
the
it.
Reason
can you give me time?
I'll give you. don't worry. Give me one second. So I am telling you, for me, I believe my Jesus is God. He came from God because he explained to me. He had many scriptures as well. But now you explain.
Okay, look, you believe in you believe
God, God of confusion.
Okay, you believe in Jesus God.
Is your God a God of confusion?
Okay, let me finish. You believe that Jesus is God. Yeah, but when you
according
look at it, according to the Bible, there is not a single verse in the Bible where Jesus claimed to be God. Not a single verse. Listen to me, and there's not a single verse where Jesus said, "Worship me." No, John 1:1. Okay, come to John. Into John 1:1. Okay,
let me.
This not Jesus. No, let me finish. Let me talk now. Let me finish. Jesus, John 1:1. It's a Jesus word. Just said that. But when he got your John, the same John, John chapter 8, verse number 42. John 8:42. You know what Jesus said? John 8:40. Jesus said. He said, and Jesus said to them, "Listen to me. If God were your Father, you would love me. For I have come here from God. I have not come on my own. God sent me."
Yes,
listen to me. Now let us think. I said there's not a single verse. If you look at the Bible, Jesus is making distinction between Almighty God. Why don't you read those verses? Listen to me. Jesus also said in Gospel of John, in St. John 8:40, he said to his enemies, "But now you seek to kill me, a man who has told you the truth, which I have from God." Was Jesus a man? Yes, and he's a man. Yeah. So listen. So why did Jesus say that? "But now you seek to kill me, a man who has told you the truth, which I have from God." Who is that God?
Let me tell you something.
I mean, this is incredible. Not
know,
a single
it's not
what?
Incredible.
No,
it's not
show me. No,
what?
What did Muslim say? Let me finish. I'll give it. Okay. What I want to know, everybody say, show us a single verse. Why Jesus? Yeah, in any way, shape, or form, say he's God or worship me. You can't. So Jesus came on the earth. Yeah, he preached for how many years? So he taught the disciples. He never said he's God. He never said worship me. He said to them, "Was he Almighty God?" He said to them, "Guess what? The Lord our God." You know, in the Gospel of Mark 12:29, what he said? A scribe came. He said, "Master," he said, "What he said to me? What is the first? The first of all the commandments? You break it." What he said? "The first of the all the commandments is, hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord." He didn't say the Lord your God, the Lord our God, including him. You break the commandment.
No, don't get angry.
That's what I told.
No, emotion. Passion.
I'm a Maninka, you know, Maninka.
Passion.
Soldier, yeah. Sorry about this.
No,
it's all right.
Go on. So that is why, if you can show us, don't worry, Jesus' own words.
For example, I have to tell you now, you want the specific word that Jesus said, "I am God." Okay, that's what you want.
Jesus cannot do that.
He was a man. He cannot say, "Worship me," because he's a man. People are going to go and worship a man.
But he said he's God.
But she is
God. He said he's God.
Show you.
He said he's God.
But you are saying it worship a man.
He's a man. He said because he's a man.
But she's
so calling
for him.
No. On earth he was not born. He's a divine human, remember?
Okay, but in heaven, what is he in heaven? He's God in heaven.
Absolutely.
Okay, see? He's
coming back again.
Jesus is God in heaven. Jesus is God in heaven.
Absolutely.
Listen to me.
No,
listen one more. In the gospel, Jesus is not God in heaven. In your Bible, said he's not God.
Absolutely. He's with the Father.
Bible said,
do you know any prophet is with God?
Let me tell you why Jesus is not God in heaven. I'll tell you. You are not telling the truth. You know why? If you read your Bible, no, he's not laughing.
Yeah, you can see. It's a block.
Gospel of Luke. No, read it. Gospel of Luke 22:69.
Let me tell you something.
You know what he said?
Let me tell you something.
No, let's say Jesus in heaven.
Do you believe what I read to you in John 1st?
Don't.
Do you believe?
No, I'll come to you. I'll debunk it.
Oh, so why do you don't talk about
it? I'm going to debunk it.
Why are you not talking about it?
I'm going to debunk it now.
Why?
No, Jesus on earth is a man. In heaven is God.
Okay.
Do you know Gospel of Luke, chapter 22, verse number 69. You know what he said? And we see now that the Son of Man, that Jesus, is seated at the right hand of the mighty God.
Well, okay.
Who is the mighty God?
Muhammad seated with
No, who is the mighty God?
No.
Muhammad is not God. He's not God. He never said God.
He never been.
Jesus is not God. Why is Jesus seated at the right hand of the mighty God? Who is the mighty God?
He's God.
Who is the mighty God? You cannot, my sister, you fail.
I'm not failing.
He said Jesus is a man. If heaven is God. But now that Jesus is seated.
Muhammad tell you, do not believe Allah has a son.
I don't blame you. Your Quran says that.
Oh, go to the
church.
All the pictures
is white.
Because your Quran tell you to not believe.
No. Is he a son of God in your Bible or is he God himself? You're confusing.
Yeah.
You're jumping now to son now.
How confusing Quran is. You're gonna be embarrassed right now.
Now you're
shall I embarrass you right now? Do you want me to embarrass
you? You see this Bible here?
I know you don't like it, but you do.
You see the Bible here? This Bible here? Look at me, sister.
Worship who Jesus worships.
Which one do you, no, which one do you believe in?
No, I was nice.
They are not the same.
I was nice to you. Let me tell you something.
No, I said they are not the same. Only one Quran.
What was good enough for Jesus should be good enough for you.
That's one. Don't even go there. Bring the Quran. How many Qurans are there?
So don't add
another. Bring them. See, the Bible, see, they are not the same. You know what?
You can't say that. You have 20 Qurans.
Your speech, 20 Quran. You know what? Just go and check. He run away from me like a chicken. Do you know here? Let me see, sister. Do you know what he said?
Yeah.
No, bring the Quran, bring it. No.
Let's read the Quran.
The King James Version has grave defects.
Brother,
but in the middle of the 19th century, the development of biblical studies and discovery of many manuscripts,
brother, you're not listening.
More incident than those upon
which the King. This is my Bible.
The Quran. So you don't believe in this one?
No.
You don't believe in your Bible?
Do
you believe in that?
No.
He just came now. He's been talking a lot.
He just came now. Yeah, that's the thing. Wait. Brother.
I'm not angry. No, I'm a Mandinka. I'm African.
You're excited. You think like you win or anything. You haven't won.
No, I'm not saying I win.
You believe the Quran, I believe my Bible. Look. You agree that?
Which one? Which Bible? This one or this one?
You call me. You are debating with uncle.
The
and the uncle was tired. He said, are you a Muslim? Come and debate with you. I'm going to show you. Jesus is God. Now you cannot show me. Jesus is God.
You call me.
There is only one.
Nobody can show me.
And
now you're being blamed for Muslims.
So what is the meaning of God?
I'll leave it to you. I'll leave you a court. I'll leave you a talker.
Let me tell you something, brother.
You cannot show us where. That's what I'm saying. That's all I want to know. Jesus is not God.
You see, I can't speak. I'm not going to debate with you. No way. But if I show you a Quran, how confusing, how evil it is, you will be embarrassed.
This is the question I ask you.
Brother.
Is your prophet Muhammad received verses from Satan? Listen.
Once he finished, you go.
No.
Did he did?
Listen to me.
Is it from God? Is Gabriel angel telling you everything? That's why you guys are confused.
You can't.
You need to come to Jesus. You need to be saved. Muhammad lost you. And I feel sorry for you.
Uncle, you are preaching now, your auntie
or
sister,
Satan.
You feel miserably.
No.
You call me, you're going to show me Jesus is God. And now you are emotional, you can't show
Satan.
Me. Okay.
He is or not?
Just
yes
give
or not?
A single verse. Why Jesus? In any way or shape or
form, say God. No. From Satan versus, he said all
see, this is the problem.
He kills people.
My sister, come to Islam. Jesus was a Muslim. Jesus was a Muslim.
Follow Muhammad?
No, Jesus was a Muslim.
Follow Muhammad?
You know Jesus was a Muslim?
No,
we're not talking about Jesus. Did Jesus have a God?
Jesus is God. He's excellent.
Did he have a God?
He's pure. He's the one.
I know, okay. We believe in that Jesus have a God. We believe in Jesus.
I don't think so. You don't know Jesus.
Did Jesus
have a God? Jesus in the Quran is not my Jesus.
Did Jesus have a God?
That is the same.
You're right.
It's a fake Jesus. You're right. You're a fake Jesus.
Yeah.
The Jesus you worship.
Jesus in the Quran is not my
Jesus. Jesus you worship.
It is not my Jesus.
I know you are following a fake Jesus.
Listen.
The Jesus of the Romans. We believe that.
Shall I show you that? I'll show you. Let me show you.
No, I'm going to go because the thing is now, sister. You call me.
No, but
you cannot. No, I'm not running. I want to show you.
I cannot run away. Do you know your Quran is messed up? Completely upside down. Shall I show you?
Show me.
Yes, you haven't even studied
your Bible. Yeah, and Lord, he said the Quran is corrupted.
Yes,
and I've got so many Bibles there. I can show you corruption upon corruption. Your Bible, yeah, they're not the same.
I've got
corruption
on
here.
Show me one of the corruption.
One of the corruption. Don't say, I like you, boy. I like my ass. Let me show corruption. Okay.
He's lying.
Let me. I'm not lying. Let me show you. He wants to show corruption. Wait.
Honestly, I feel sorry for you guys. Come to Jesus. He will save you. You don't even know you're going to heaven or not.
Jesus, your Jesus couldn't save himself from dying.
Please don't say that. The Jews
he couldn't save himself.
So you don't know Jesus. There is no your problem.
Your Jesus couldn't save himself.
No,
he was killed by the Romans.
Wait.
It's a shame that you.
It's incredible. Agree.
He was killed by the Romans.
Let me tell you something.
Very weak God. Your God is weak.
Okay, let's just.
Your God is very weak.
Why do you understand?
Your God is weak. He died. They killed him.
Okay. Let me finish that. Otherwise, we get distracted. Let me finish.
All right.
26.
All right, yeah.
You understand? A false God, a false prophet.
Here.
That's why you want to hear. I've got
the false
prophet. Yeah. Such an evil. I'm telling you guys. Okay. I'm sorry for you.
Your guy, your guy died.
Really 26.
The Roman killed your God.
I'll show you the difference from here.
He has to die for our sin.
He died.
For our sin.
Roman killed him.
Okay, wait. Let me finish that. We are doing something here.
Yes.
No, we're doing something here. Hold on. Okay. Yeah. Act 3.
We are not
Act 3, 26.
God don't die, sister.
Act 3.
God don't die.
Act 3, 26.
God don't die.
Hold on.
Death does not exist.
He didn't say God.
Hold on, coming.
You just Jesus said died for our sin.
So Jesus
don't
God.
Mix it.
Jesus God.
Is he a problem? Yes, he's your God. You better worship him. You better bow down before him.
Is it God?
Yes.
You just said he's not God.
Yes.
Can he
see your
Quran? Can he see your
Quran? Okay, wait.
Can he see how many wrong in your Quran?
Okay. Let me finish the debate. We're doing something.
You want to record this?
Yeah.
This is your scholar.
He's not a scholar. He's not a scholar.
Act 3:26. The same. Okay. Let me finish.
Yes.
Let me finish that. Yeah. Act 3:26.
Yeah.
What do you say? I'll tell you the difference.
Unto you first, God.
Yeah.
Having raised up his son.
Having raised up his son.
Jesus.
Yeah.
Sent him to bless you.
Yeah.
In turning away every one of you from his iniquity.
Yeah. So in this fear, he said, Jesus is the Son of God. Yeah? Mm-hmm. Act 3:26. Yeah? Mm-hmm. Act 3:26 in here, they change it.
Let me read.
This is the New King James Version. Let me read it. You can read this, yeah?
Why did you read your Quran?
Let me finish. He said, to you first God, having raised up his servant. Servant Jesus.
Continue.
Servant. Sent him to bless you in turning away every one of you from your iniquities. So it's a servant. It's Jesus. It's Jesus. No. Hold on. No. What? Servant of God. Jesus is servant of God. Not a son of God. Then. He said servant of God. These three said servant of God. At 3:26. He is a son of God. Which one is it?
Listen. You might shout from
the other. No, that's it. That's why
we don't see him.
That's terrible.
No, last week.
His passion is okay.
No, hold on.
His passion about his religion.
See this here. Last week.
Jesus Christ.
You and Hashim. You are shouting.
No, Hashim make a first statement.
No.
We have Jesus. We have the original.
You
have the one he died. You have the fake one. The one he died. We don't have the one he died. We have the one God take him up.
Okay, let me finish. Explain that to me.
Act 3.
Yeah.
He's talking about Act 3, 26.
26, yeah. What's the difference?
This only Bible King James Version.
Yeah,
definitely.
Yeah.
When you translate from the manuscript.
Yeah.
A lot of manuscripts were written in Greek to Latin.
Yeah.
The Vortex Latina.
Yeah.
The Vulgate and the rest.
So you can look
right. There are a lot of translations. And when you do translation, definitely, the King James Version was the first that was translated into English.
Yes.
From Koine English to normal English, right?
Yeah.
So, for simplicity, there are a lot of things that are synonymous to each other. Take for example, Jesus Christ is the Son of God. And likewise, they use servant of God in the new translation to also refer to him as God worthy. As God worthy. You understand? As God worthy, that he worship God.
No.
Why don't stop him? Let him talk.
No, I don't want
so,
to
okay, so,
is lecture or what is it?
I don't want
lecturing now.
I'm lecturing you because you need to be lecturing.
No, you are debating.
Yes. No.
You need to be lecturing. It's not debate.
Yes.
You understand?
I need to be lectured. Okay.
You need to be lectured.
He got lectured by Hashim last week.
At that point in time, when Jesus Christ was on earth, he was a human being. We reference God Almighty.
Yes.
And at that point in time, he was sent. He himself said he was sent. And he that was sent, at that point in time, was a servant.
Yes.
You understand? At that point in time,
don't
was a servant.
No, he's lecturing. I'm going. He's lecturing.
That is why they use servant.
I'll finish with you anyway, so I'm going.
That's why they use servant there, and they use
servant. Okay, let me talk.
He will answer.
Let me talk.
Let him answer.
So is that corruption?
Let me.
This is the Quran.
Sister, I'm finished with you. You cannot show me anywhere.
I'll
finish with you now.
Brother.
So I finish with you. You can't.
Yes or no?
Okay.
Answer my question. Yes or no? No corruption.
It's corruption.
That wasn't corruption. What is corruption? Define corruption.
Let me talk now.
Divine corruption.
Can I finish talking first?
No, divine corruption.
Let me finish talking.
You won't talk until you have divine corruption. Because people are so good at using...
No.
If you are not there, they are so good at using psych.
But you don't...
To come there, and make you confused.
Are you talking to him or her?
So, I'm talking to the camera.
Hello, my brother. I'm from Gambia. I'm a Mandinka.
Yeah, I'm from Nigeria.
Yeah, I'm a warrior. King warrior, yeah?
So listen to me. I'm also a warrior.
The king is talking.
I'm also a warrior.
The king warrior.
So now,
listen.
The question is...
Let me talk now.
The question is that corruption, yes or no?
Okay, let me talk.
It's a yes or no question. Yes or no question.
Let me talk.
Answer his question.
The Bible is a corruption... That is, so let me finish.
Can you provide?
Let me provide.
Can you provide the uncorrupted Bible?
I'll show you the corruption if you listen to me.
I wanted to play Ashim video for him yesterday. He ran away.
Brother, do you want to answer? Allow him to ask.
You're listening. Do you know what a contradiction is? Contradiction.
Let him, sister,
you're accusing me. Now, yeah.
Don't let
me
know.
You debunked. You know, I debunked you now.
I debunked you. He gave it to you guys. He lied to
you. Your God died.
No, you can't give up. I debunked his sister here. Call me. He's going to show me. Come. Are you a Muslim? I'll show you Jesus is God. I debunked her now. Now she will keep going.
He's God.
Okay.
Maybe you will show people when you come back. Now they have a sniper.
And I will show you the Bible.
Let me talk.
All my prayer will go.
Why are you not saying? Why
are you not saying? Give me that again.
You see all these Bibles here.
What about if we die again now?
Okay, you read all these Bibles.
Yes, definitely.
You read all of them.
The word of God.
All of them.
Yeah.
Okay, but you know this one says, this one here, that's what I'm saying.
What? If you are bringing all of them, how many Qurans do you have?
Can you imagine 36?
No, yes. let me finish. This one here, say this is corrupted.
You bring them
how many do you have?
Okay, no, let me finish.
Okay,
this one say, you believe in all this, but he said yes. As a word of God. No, let me finish. This one is corrupted. What do you say? It's corrupted. What do you say about that?
Can you listen?
No, finish that. No, don't digress. I asked you, you believe in all the Bibles.
How many do you have? I said they're not the same.
You didn't answer my question. Why should I answer?
See, you're a waste of time. Now I'm going now because I'm finished.
Why should I answer?
I'm here. You're a waste of time.
So, why are you talking about Bible?
You're a waste of time.
No, I'm not a waste of time. You people don't. You don't know anything.
But you said you believe in all these Bibles. I said this one said this is corrupted. What do you say about that?
This one said this is corrupted.
Yeah.
Open
it. Can I read it?
I don't care about whatever I
say. Yeah! What?
Listen.
Now, what's it? You are disingenuous. This man is insincere.
It's only one. No,
you are on his head. No.
You're
you said you believe in all the words. No, you make me laugh. You know why you make me laugh? Because you said laugh now. You believe in all the Bible. I said this one said this is corrupted.
Everybody, if you listen to me, every Bible, and I've told you to show me what corruption is.
Show me a video about
divine corruption.
Give me two.
Divine corruption. Let me see.
Divine corruption.
Yeah.
Okay. Let me.
And how it relates to
how many Qurans they have?
Okay. About divine corruption. Let me see.
Brother,
can you just cut? We're debating. No, we're debating, sister. Sister, let's debate. If you want to debate with me, let me finish. No, let's finish. Yeah.
And how it relates?
I define.
Listen.
Let me define it for you.
Can you just listen? Divine corruption. Divine corruption and how it relates to the verses of the Bible.
Okay, let me listen.
Did you get it? Divine corruption and how it relates. Listen, I want you to
go. Boom.
I don't want you to go this way. I want to guide you.
Wait, I want to guide you. Matthew 13:13. See they see not, hearing they hear not, never will they understand. Jesus is describing the Bible.
Like
Matthew 30.
Like
but
you.
He's not listening to me.
I just want you to divine
me. Let me talk again.
You both divine are just talking. He's talking to
you. Wait. Can we all keep quiet, please? The question is this. Can you divine the Bible? Corruption. Corruption according to how it relates to verses of all this Bible.
Okay, wait. Okay. And you keep quiet. Don't interrupt me. Whatever I do, after if they're not satisfied, can talk. Here.
I keep quiet.
You see this Bible here, keep quiet. Yeah, all these Bibles here, I've got so many Bibles. The brother said he believes in all of them. But this one here said the King James Version corrupted.
Sorry, don't listen. Let me keep your Bible.
No, here. This one said this is corrupted. So you can answer here. Let me read it to you. That's who tell you corruption. They mean corrupted. They give the means of corruption. He said here. Yet the King James.
Who wrote this one?
Christian scholars of 32.
Let me tell you something. Before I proceed, I know where
God, I'm going.
Listen.
Okay, I'm going.
Listen. When he wants to
debate,
talk,
he's not debating.
He can't debate me. When he wants to talk,
can we have a moderator?
There are.
Can we have a moderator? Moderator. 3 minutes. No. 3 minutes.
Someone
help me, moderator. 3 minutes.
There are some people. Okay. There are some enthusiasts.
Moderator. 2 minutes.
Listen. There are some enthusiasts.
Go back to Africa. Wait. Yeah.
It's
racist. Stop that. Stop that and start again. Stop that.
There are some enthusiasts.